Hey guys, today I'm going to teach you how to make this Scarlet Witch magic energy effect in the free version of DaVinci Resolve. I'm going to be making this effect in the Fusion tab. If Fusion isn't your cup of tea or you just don't want to go through the trouble of making the effect, I've got you covered. I will put a pre-rendered version of this effect in the description of the video, and it's loopable, so it can just keep on going till they stop making Marvel movies. Alright, to start off, we're going to go to the Effects library, down to Effects, and just drag down a Fusion Composition. I'm going to make it about 10 seconds long, but it really doesn't matter. So the Scarlet Witch effect, or the way I did it, is a particle-based. So for every particle-based effect, you're going to need at least two things, a particle emitter and a particle renderer. So there are a bunch of different ways you can bring those. You can, on this top screen, not screen, this top toolbar thing right here, you can bring down a P emitter and a P renderer. Then you can just click on this little square right here and then just drag it over. Then I'm gonna hit 2. And there it is. Another way you could do it is hit Shift and Space on the keyboard and just search for it. So P emitter, and then again Shift Space, and then P render. So those are just two different ways. You could also right click, add tool, go down, try to find it in this thing, but who's got time for that? All right, so I'm going to hit 2, bring this to the viewer. Drag that down. Alright, so this is the 3D workspace. It can seem a little daunting at first, but it's actually not that bad, and you're probably going to need it for a lot of effects. Alright, so some basic controls you want for the 3D thing. You're going to need to have a 3 mouse. That's just a mouse with a mouse wheel on it. So if you're trying to do this on the touchpad, good luck. So to pan around, you hold down the middle mouse button, which is just the scroll wheel. You move it around, so you can just pan around like that. Another thing is if you scroll the mouse wheel, you can just go up and down. Another thing, control and moving the mouse wheel, you can zoom in and out. Also, if you hold Alt and the mouse wheel and drag that around, you can rotate it. Also, another way you can do that, what I've never seen in any tutorial do this, but it works, you can do the middle mouse and right click, and you can rotate like that, and it's way easier for me because I don't gotta reach up to the keyboard every time. All right, so these right here are particles being emitted in that little green square you can see. That's not a square, that's a circle. All right, so these are the basic controls. I'm gonna leave them as they are for now. So right now the particles are just being born, not doing anything, and dying. They're just existing. And we want them to do more than exist. We want them to live. In order to get them to move, you might think you'd go to the velocity or rotation or anything like that. And you can get basic movements with those and do that. They're just flying that way, but that's not what we're going to be doing for this. Go that back to default. I'm going to do Shift Space and add a P Turbulence. So right off the bat, you can see that it's doing something. Gives it this nice organic kind of blown in the wind wavy motion like that. It's going a bit slow for my taste, so I'm going to take the X Strength, put that at 0.3. Same for point Y. I mean, same for the Y Strength. And Z Strength, I'll put it 0.2. Alright, I like that motion. So each of these particles, you can see, is just one pixel. And when you're playing around with particles, when you're trying to get the motion down, I would recommend having it on the style point, so it's just one pixel, and it doesn't take long for the computer render, so you can get almost always real time. And since it doesn't take that long, I'm going to bring up the number of particles to, say, 85. That's better. It gives it more thickness, but now it's just chaos. They're just going everywhere. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to bring down the lifespan up until, let's see, maybe 35. All right, so there, you can see them moving around, but they don't live long enough to cause much damage. But they're kind of just like shooting into existence and then just disappearing. So what I'm going to do to fix that is go into the style under fade controls, And I'm just going to fade them in a little bit and fade them out. So now they have a slow kind of fade away and it looks much more organic and much more pleasing. All right, so this could work for you. You could just stop right here, but I'm gonna go one step further and add a P directional force to give it kind of an upward motion of energy. But when we add that, it does the exact opposite of what we want it to do. So we can take the direction, take away that negative 90. Now it's positive 90, but that is way too much motion upwards. So I'm gonna take the strength, gonna put it something really low, like 0.0186, just random numbers like that. All right, that has a nice upward motion. Another thing to do to make it just really subtle is I'm gonna go to the, what is this? The conditions tab, and then take down the probability to somewhere about maybe 4. Yeah, somewhere about that. So that only like this percentage of the particles, so only 37% of the particles will be affected by this directional force. All right, so I like that. So now we are going to leave the wonderful world of 3D and the render, go from the output mode, put it to 2D. So now it's a 2D, that's a 2D thing. It's kind of hard to see right now with this checker underlay, so I'm gonna right click, go down to options, uncheck checker underlay. So now it's on a back black, on a black background. Try saying that 5 times fast. All right, so now it's kind of hard to see. So if you zoom in, you can get it, but if you zoom out, they're just kind of sparkly. So what I'm gonna do to fix that is we're going to do shift space and add a blur. I'm gonna click on that, hit 2, bring that to the viewer. All right, that softens them up nicely. I'm actually gonna bring the blur up to 5.5. Well, now we can barely see them. It's just kind of a blob. So what I'm going to do is add a soft glow. Bring that to the viewer, let it render. Gonna take the gain, bring it all the way up. So now we can see it better. It's running a little slowly. So what you can do is right next to the play things, you can right click and turn off high quality and motion blur. We're not going to be using any motion blur. All right, that should make it render just a little bit faster. All right, so now we're going to actually start taking this motion and making it actually look like this cool energy effect that we all know and love. So I'm going to add a, I'm going to put BC to get a brightness contrast and bring up the gain, something about maybe 3 point. All right, that looks good. And it looks kind of blown out right now, but that's really gonna help sell the effect because it's this energy and it has, if you look in the movies, they're like this almost like white core. So that's gonna help that. Take the media out, always gets in the way until the very end. So just push it over to the side, I'm sorry. All right, so what we're gonna do is hit shift space and add an abstraction node. This node changes basically the whole thing and makes it look beautiful. So I'm gonna bring that to the viewer. Let it render. The abstraction node takes a while to render sometimes. It's a more heavy node. It looks terrible. Would I lie to you like that? Just chill. I'm gonna change some settings so that it actually looks good. So take the abstraction strength down to somewhere around 0.02. And that appeared to do absolutely nothing. But then, when we go to the edge strength, maybe bring that somewhere around 0.7, and that gives it these nice, almost cloudy details. If we look at where it was before, this almost pinches it in, gives it that nice texture. And again, this takes a while, so you probably won't get real-time playback from this point on, unless you have like some kind of supercomputer. All right, that looks nice. So then I'm going to add a vector distortion. So I'm going to take the scale and bring it down to maybe about 0.3. And this is just something I like. It gives us just a little bit more of these kind of cloudy look. You see it kind of has those like darkened things in the middle. Just gives it a little bit more detail. All right. So you could be done with this and have a nice, almost like cloudlet kind of thing. But this next thing is going to give it way more of that energy look. So gonna add an erode dilate. Bring that to the viewer. Change the filter to circle. And if you change the amount, you see it kind of pinches it in. But what we want is for it to only be pinched in certain places to give it that kind of more random organic. So what we're going to do is go up here, add a fast noise, drag that down. I'm going to put that in the viewer. All right, so what I'm going to do is take the detail, bring that up a little bit, take the contrast somewhere around, maybe, yeah, that looks good to me. Then take the scale up to somewhere around 15, all right? Then switch it to discontinuous. So you have these little bands right here. Now take the seethe rate, maybe around 0.3, and then if you watch that play, this should play much faster. You have this nice organic evolving kind of thing. So we're going to use that to drive our erosion. If I bring that here and take the output of this and drag it into this little blue area, which should be the effect mask, and then bring down the amount, maybe, yeah, that looks good. So you can see that the fast noise, the parts that are black, only those parts are being eroded in. So it pinches certain parts in and gives it that kind of organic, cloudy, gives another level of dimension. So you go from this to that. All right, so we're actually done with styling the effect. Now we're going to color it. So there are a bunch of different ways you can do this. For what I did, I used Tintensity, if I can spell it. TNT, Tintensity. This is a free fuse from Learn Now Effects. It's on Reactor, which is also free, so I like it. It gives some really nice controls. All I do is bring the color to red, maybe change the vibrance mode to power. Just bring that up. Have a nice scarlet witch effect. Turn it actually red. Or if you don't have that plugin, something in my throat, you can also use a CC, a color corrector node. Bring that up there. And then drag the output into that. If you just drag it over to red, it's a little bit much. Maybe bring up the saturation. I'll put two screens to compare the two. I need to put that one on no check underlay. It's basically the same. Another way you could do this, if the color corrector doesn't work for you, you could also go down here. Going to add a merge. Bring this in, bring this down. Then, so let's look at that. And take a background that will be red. Bring it into this green, which would be the foreground of the merge. And change the apply mode to overlay. That's looking way, way saturated. So you can just take this and bring it down to the more desaturated. So, bunch of different ways you can colorize it. I'm just going to stick with Tintensity because that's what I use, but all of these should work. And of course, you don't have to make it red. You can make it green, have more of a maleficent fire, or blue looks cool, kind of like the will-o-wisp things from Brave, but since WandaVision is what's the thing right now, I'm going to keep it red. All right, so we are almost done. Next, what we're going to do is hit shift space and add a sharpen. So go back to one viewer, zoom in. So the sharpen just helps bring out some of the details in the thing. So I'm going to put it at 1.5. Looks good. So you go from this, which is a little bit blurrier, to this, which brings out these nice like ripples right here. So, and then this last step seems to go without saying, but is very important. Drag it into the media out so it can be seen in the edit tab, you don't know how many times I have finished an effect and forgot to bring it into the media out. All right, so now we're in the edit tab. So once this red line turns blue, we can watch it in real time. All right, it's finished rendering for me. It took about 5 minutes, give or take. I always hate when tutorials just skip through it without telling you how long it actually took for them. So if you hit play, you now have real-time playback of your Scarlet Witch effect. If you want to learn how to composite this into your footage, I have a tutorial on that. And if you enjoyed this tutorial, if you wouldn't mind liking. If there's an effect that you want me to do a tutorial for, please leave a comment below. I would be happy to do my best. All right, I'm out.